Fair enough.
I gotta get this. Raining outside.
Yeah, I think they can hear us. The kids are outside waiting for us. Should we show up?
Welcome to the Jet Jet Show. My name is Jet, and today I got my little brother here today. You're probably gonna be like, who's talking?
Hey, that's my line.
I'm with me.
Damn.
Today.
Hey, what's up, you guys? Welcome to the Jet Jet Show. I'm Jetty Jet, and we got an awesome show for you today. We have this amazing artist with us. We got with us today, Mr.
Jibby
Fried Rice.
Yeah.
What's up, Jibby?
Hey, how's it going?
What's going on, Jibby? Jibby Chow Mein. What you been up to, man?
Just drawing a lot. I'm feeling pretty confident.
Nice.
So,
you feeling pretty loose?
Yeah.
Pretty stretched out.
Yeah. Wow. We got some turnout here today.
Did you do your taxes?
Of course.
Kids.
You didn't do your taxes.
Wait, who told you that?
you did. You were like, I was like, hey, let's draw. You were like, I didn't do my taxes. Like, it's freaking July.
We had an extension, okay? God, we had so much. It was the most hectic ass tax season of my entire life. And I spent like 3 years in the bunkers just taxing it out.
Oh yeah.
Taxing it out.
You gotta.
Yeah, because
you really
I did so many things this year. I did like 20 shows. Okay, so imagine this, right? So you wanna make sure you can write off as much as you possibly can, lower the amount you owe in taxes. If you have you're running a business, you're paying taxes up front. So I'm calculating table cost, plane tickets, luggage,
dang,
car rental. Like sometimes it'd be two cars, sometimes two lodging, like Airbnb and hotels, and then dinners for everybody. Prints costs, packaging costs, and then all the food and dining that I would pay for everybody during the trips. And that's one show. So multiply that by 20.
That's insane.
Yeah, and so it's insane. I don't know if I can do this for. What's up, you guys? Welcome to the show. How you doing, Jibby?
Enough about taxes.
Jibby Fried Rice. I'm so happy you're here, man. Thanks for thanks for showing up.
No problem.
Yeah, so let's see what we got here. We have we're sketching with Jetty, featuring Jibby Fried Rice. This is Jibby, and we're using his sketch. This is a sketch that I just pulled up. Let's close out these little things. So tell me about this. What is this? What is this? Because I haven't been on Instagram. This is like, we probably talked for 5 minutes before the show. Jimmy was the one who suggested we do stream. So I said, all right, you know what? I need to work anyway. So turn on the music.
All right. What are you showing right now? I'm looking.
Oh, my God.
We got.
They couldn't hear us this whole time. Just kidding. No, just kidding. Just kidding.
I was about to say, holy crap.
No, I just turned down the music.
All right.
This one is, I really don't know why I'm wearing a cape.
Are you sharing your screen right now? Let's see.
Yeah, I'm sure.
I don't know.
Hey, Jeju-san. Let me know if you can see my screen. Yeah, son.
There you go. Okay. I see your screen.
I'm going to be recording my screen as well as casting my stream to the internet. So there's just a lot of recording and latency stuff going on, and I don't want to like slow it down. So I will not be sharing it with you, Jibbers.
That's fine.
I will just share.
I'll just look at it through YouTube. Okay.
Cam, I can see. Yes, Jeju, I know I can count on you, man. Thank you. He can see. Can you hear? He probably can't hear right now. Damn it.
Let us know if you guys can hear us.
Let me know if you can hear. That should be the first question, Jeju.
Dumb as hell. Oh my god.
And that's the stream.
Alright.
I got your screen showing now. Okay. So.
Alright.
Yeah. Tell me what have you been up to? What have you been working on? Do you have a. Do you have art to share with us?
Sure.
Let me see some of your stuff before we get started, because we're gonna be sketching today. We're gonna be sketching together. So I hope you guys pull up a sketchbook and sketch.
Pull up my Instagram.
Yeah. I can
pull it up. I've been having a lot of fun.
I can pull up your Instagram if you want me to do that.
I'll do it because, you know, I want to see what I'm looking at and not comment like 10 seconds late.
So listen.
Yeah.
Whoa! What the hell? Whoa. You've been on... Oh, shit.
I've been dropping a lot of stuff.
Wow.
Let's start off.
The last drawing I've seen was your little witch.
Yeah.
That was the last one I saw. And look at that. This is what I'm talking about.
Yeah, I feel like I was just really just trying to find my shapes, my style. Yeah. I usually get really rusty if I don't draw for like a few weeks. Yeah. But then recently I've been trying to just draw something every single day. So let's start off with, you know, I guess a lot of guys probably don't know who I am. I'm pretty obscure. I'm like on and off with, you know, activity. And mainly because I don't have an art job. I work like a pretty normal job.
Yeah.
And, you know, just doing art on the side, which is
just freelance totally a little bit here and there for art studios and stuff.
Yeah, pretty much.
Commissions. That's good.
Let's see. Yeah. Often, it's my Instagram. You guys can go check it out. My name is Jimmy Fried Rice.
Jimmy Fried Rice.
Let's start off with one of my favorite ones, I guess. This is me and my my girlfriend. I don't know. It was a lot of fun.
Like Cora to me.
Huh?
Maybe I'm delayed. I see Cora.
Cora. That's Katara. Go look on the Discord.
Okay, I'm stupid. Okay, there's a delay on the OBS. Just go ahead. Just go ahead. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm just super impressed because like this is what I'm always talking about, and I'm always hammering this home for everybody. Like you just gotta keep doing it and be consistent. And it looks like Jibby is finally finding his stride. This is the most I don't want to like over boast you for you because that usually kills productivity. You ever heard of that?
Yeah,
it's like when you feel like you've achieved something that makes you complacent. Like I've done enough work.
Yeah,
you've not done enough. You've only started. Okay, this is you need to do five of the
warm ups. I'd say because I want to start doing a comic.
Yeah,
and really just trying to find my my stride. I feel like I've been getting a lot faster with most of these.
Yeah,
first you know the line work and figuring the perspective was a little challenging, but eventually I started to just figure something out.
Yeah,
things started to click with a lot of things. You know, you get that, you know, that incline where things start to make sense and then it starts to be steady.
You get that hit that stride. You just like
hit that stride, you know, and then the incline again. Yeah,
you're just jogging.
Yeah, pretty much just jogging, figuring things out, just doing fan art to see like comparisons and
how
my shapes differ from other art styles. See, I got Dragon Ball, I got Dragon Quest, I got Avatar. I've been just the stuff I've been watching, stuff I've been into. Been doing like my original characters as well.
Mm-hmm.
Fan art for my friends. You know, playing a lot of Smash. I just picked up Granblue Fantasy Versus. So
nice.
Cloud and Toon Link. I use Toon Link. And my girlfriend uses Cloud when we play doubles in Smash. So it's just been a lot of fun doing that. So I just decided to do this for us, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
Then I did character of my friend's character, which I enjoyed drawing a lot. He has like a lot of similar shapes that I use, but I did it more in my style, I suppose.
Yeah.
Another character of my friend's. Just, you know, I asked my friends like, hey, can I draw your character? And they say, you know, sure. And then I try to figure out some shapes and change things up to see like how I differ from the thought process, I suppose. And, you know, I did this in like really quick. I wanted to see if, you know, how you say like my...
Pause for a second. I moved my Discord screen so you shifted a bit. Okay. But you're good now. I just want to make sure it's clear. It's kind of distorted. But like we're getting like some lag. Yeah, I mean, we can tell what's going on. Just keep going.
Yeah. Like you said, I should try to go for a more loose approach with the style. And I try to go like with really, really loose lines here. So nice. I guess that's let's see.
Yeah, man, that's what you gotta do. You gotta keep, let me see. I'm gonna go
that's through. Lagging on the YouTube, I think.
Is it YouTube?
Yeah.
Alright, well, those are some questions here. You guys have any questions at all? Hey, Marcho, he says he really liked the tutorials. Oh, the tutorials. The non-existent tutorials. Here, I'm gonna go to my screen.
Go ahead.
My screen is much more clean and clear, so I think there must be some lag on your end. Could be, or it could be because I'm streaming your Discord and you're sharing through Discord. So
probably
Discord has a lot of lag. Here, let me just click through this real quick. We got the guy with the knife on the floor, on the ground. Much more clear, crispy clean. Sugar Rush. Oh, it's so lovely. The shapes, man. The simplicity. You see, simplicity. There's thinking.
Thank you.
That's what we call simplicity can also be described as sophistication. Sophistication, simplicity. Because it's easy to draw something complex and go with like a million details, but can you represent that complexity with simplicity? Can you represent that simplicity? If you can, that's what we call sophistication.
Thank you. Bye.
Yeah, so let's not linger around for that too much. Let's sketch. What do you want to sketch for us today? You gonna sketch for us? So I'll be doing sketching a little bit. But let's see here.
Oh wow. I got a pretty deep comment.
What they said.
It says, "Hey Jimmy, can you tell us about your weight loss journey and how that helped you get better at near every
not I ain't near talking every... about weight loss. I'm trying to draw. You heard this? The show is called Sketching with Jetty. Enough of Jimmy.
It applies though.
We don't need to hear about no weight loss.
Now you did back workout and ate a taco. Tell us about that.
Well, actually, I didn't get to finish because we ran out of time and I was like already late. And I did eat a taco, but more onto your workout. Yes, Jimmy did. He lost a ton of weight.
I lost a lot of weight. I was a chunky boy. I mean, if you're drawing all day and eating all day, you're just sitting down all day and then sleeping and then sitting down. When you think about, like, you know, just the whole gist of it, you're not thinking, you know, like, it takes a hit. Like, you don't realize it, but you get really big from doing that. Yeah.
Dude is spitting poetry right now. Not gonna lie, Zero Zeke.
Do this
in poetry. Not gonna lie. Anyways, if you guys ever have any questions, just definitely at me at the Jetty Jet Show, and we'll try to answer questions. So I'm gonna be trying to sketch out some areas, and Jibby's gonna do his thing as soon as this thing's it's still kind of blurring your end.
Yeah, I'm seeing it. My Clip Studio isn't lagging or anything.
Oh, wait. It looks kind of good. Wait, was that my screen or your screen? Is that yours? It's really good right now.
I just clicked out of it.
That's you. You're good. Okay, you're
Are you sure?
Yeah, you're sharp. I don't know what you did. You said you closed out of something?
Yeah, I think you're still on your screen though.
No, I'm not. It's your screen.
Oh, wait. It's still blurry.
I'm not using PC. No, it'll be clear soon.
Sure.
Yeah, don't worry about it. Don't think too much about it. Don't think too much. Maybe if I close out some of these.
Okay, it looks better now.
Yeah, exactly.
I don't have anything open, so it shouldn't be on like my end. Let's draw, I suppose.
Let's draw. Joey Actosh.
How do you, okay, can I answer this one?
He asks, how do you develop good habits and continue doing them? Well, yeah, well, you could, please.
Scheduling. Like, stick to a schedule, basically.
Stick to a schedule.
What, dude, YouTube is like bugging out. What's going on?
Why, it's not bugging out. Oh, I must have, I shrunk. Let me just switch to my screen.
Are you on drugs? What's going on?
Am I on drugs? Oh my god. Sorry, I keep forgetting. I'm shrinking and expanding the Discord window, so I get it'll slide your screen around.
Mm-hmm.
Let me get this back centered here for you guys real quick. Choka chai, you guys. Choka chai means you get smoking pot in Cambodian. He asked me if I'm smoking pot. Tell him about the schedule, habits, getting a good habits, because that's my shtick. That's my main.
That's your shtick.
I love that topic so much.
Yeah. Create a schedule for yourself and just stick to it. It's like really simple, but it's not, because a lot of time people spend mostly well, and then I hung out with him.
Yeah.
And like, I'd say like he'd spend like 30 or 40 minutes just kind of like on his phone, and I'm just here waiting for him to be like, "Hey, you ready to go to the gym yet?" And he's like, "No, just give me a second." And but he still honestly believes that he's pretty productive, and I'm like, "No, you're pretty bad at that." So, I'd say building a strong like habits, you know, the 21-day rule.
Yeah.
Where you build like neural pathways to making things more habitual. Like going, it kind of goes against your natural, right, like time clock, I suppose. But eventually you'll feel weird to not do it.
Right. You get addicted to it, and you can't stop something that you're addicted to.
Basically.
You want to create an addiction to what you're doing.
Pretty much.
Basically, what he's trying to say is you want to try to be addicted to good habits. We're always addicted to bad habits. So try to find a way to make yourself addicted to good habits.
Mm-hmm.
And the easiest way to do that, in my opinion, humbly, is to make your objective or goal as easy as possible every single day. Every single day. So if you want to draw every day, just make a habit to draw for 1 minute. Just 1 minute. Like 1 minute in the day. It doesn't matter what you draw. It's not about what you draw, how well the drawing is, or anything like that. It's the act of doing it and consistently doing that. That's going to develop the habit. But there's a big problem, because what you said was, let's see if they make sure they can see the screens. Yeah, they can see you, your stick guy. So
Yeah.
Do your drawing. We're just going to draw here. So I'm trying to get in the habit of not stopping so much while we talk, because the goal is to draw, and we tend to talk and not draw. Whenever mm-hmm. we're drawing, we just don't talk. So
yeah.
so that's a habit. But what I was trying to say was, there's the problem with habits making your schedule. We tend to sabotage yourself. It's like, yeah, you got to make a schedule. It's really as easy as making a schedule. And you said, but it's hard, right? It's easy, but it's hard, because we tend mm-hmm. to sabotage ourselves with stupid things that end up making us procrastinate or delay what we should be doing. So understanding what it is that is causing to sabotage your rhythm in your daily habits is really important too. So knowing what your bad habits are, for example.
Yes.
So you need to identify it, because I think what it comes down to is our hunger for dopamine. Dopamine is just like the pleasure chemicals when we're doing like useless things or just pleasurable things. It can be It can be emails. It can be YouTube. It can be video games. It can be prawn. It can be all kinds of food. And it can be just the most harmless looking thing. Like, hey, I'm going to go look up some references. That's just another excuse to go off and sabotage your workflow again. Right. So, knowing that any one of these can destroy your productivity is, in my opinion, the key to developing your habit. So,
took me, like, imagine, like, for me, like, I've been pretty much, well, aside from now, I've been pretty much big my whole life. Yeah. I didn't, like, know anything about nutrition, like, at all. Like, most of my family is also very big.
Right.
So it's just the idea of, it's like, I don't know how to explain it. Like, I don't know how, if you guys come from a family like mine, where we're pretty set in stone with a lot of things that we think we know. So then when you start to feel like, you know, like, it's like realizing your parents or the people that you've looked up to most of your life don't really know as much as you thought they did.
Yeah.
It gets a little sad.
It does.
But then you just kind of realize, like, you know, that's, you know, everyone's just human. We all just kind of just go about.
We're all people in different stages of progress.
Yeah, exactly.
Maturity.
So then for me, I thought I was eating healthy all the time. I didn't know, like, I thought sugar was good for you. I know sugar was better for you than, like, fat or something like that. Like, eating fat will make you fat. And then it's just, like, the complete opposite.
Oh, and yeah. Then, yeah, that's another. Well, that's actually a cultural thing that we were all taught growing up.
Yeah, it was very emphasized back in, like, the 80s and stuff.
Fake news.
Yeah. And then and now people are saying, like, you know, the whole thing with meat and stuff. But that's a different topic. I still eat meat. I love steak and stuff. But for me, I just had to, like, break down everything that I thought I knew and, like, learn everything all over again, you know?
That's all, isn't it?
Food, exercise. Like, I realized I wasn't exercising enough. Then I realized I wasn't eating enough protein or vegetables and all that stuff. And then I realized, like, a lot of stuff that I was eating is actually really, really bad for me.
That's all, isn't it?
It's all this. It's all this. It's all this. Welcome to my show. So for me, like, I was always made fun of growing up. Like, and then, you know, a lot of times, like, if you're big, you've tried to lose weight before, and then you probably didn't tell anybody because, you know, you're scared of being judged. A lot of times you feel like people are kind of waiting for you to, like, mess up
is a good word.
Yeah. And it's mainly because, like, a lot of people has gone through the same struggle as well. And for the most part, it was weird. Like, I have loose skin. Like, if you look at my I'm gonna go to my Instagram real quick and look at my picture.
Oh, you can just tell us about it. It's fine.
No, point at my saggy man.
It's okay. All right, let's go back. Go ahead.
Okay, so I have this right here. Okay. Which is a little, it's not that bad. I wear a compression shirt to push it down, but I have loose skin. And then people who understand, you know, exercise and who work out and who are, like, jacked and have these amazing bodies, they look at it and be like, wow, that's amazing.
Yeah.
Like, they're like, oh my God, that's really cool. But people who don't understand and probably never worked out a day in their life, they're just like, oh, that's gross, dude. Like, why don't you get rid of that? And I'm here, like, and it's just kind of, it's kind of way they, like, they don't realize, but they're taking away what I kind of achieved.
Oh, they didn't take nothing. They can't take it.
Yeah, for the most part.
They definitely diminished the value of their own perception, but they didn't take it from you.
Exactly. And it's really sad on their part because they see exercise as, like, oh, you just do it to look good. And it's more than that. I feel like my drawing has gotten a lot better since I started exercising.
Hey.
And it's really cool to see that for the most part. And go back to building habits. Just you have to really break down what you think you know.
Yeah.
And just kind of figure out what is the actual truth of this thing, you know?
So this now.
What about you, Bung Jet? You lost a ton of weight one time.
Not like you. But I definitely I definitely put the work in. I lost like a good chunk of weight when I was doing P90X back in the day. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Right.
So I've been I know how it goes, and it just consistently every day an hour and a half. Mm-hmm. That was like boot camp though. I wouldn't suggest that. Going through working out, man. I've just learned so much about like maintaining weight nowadays. This is my philosophy. Like exercise is a daily routine. It's just like brushing your teeth. The end goal is no longer to get fit or lean or anything like that. It's not. Like
once you get to that point.
My goal is to I'm not lean, but the thing is my eye isn't on that. My eye is to maintain that habit. Again, it's the habit is to create that routine and go through the motions. The byproduct is the health, is the aesthetics. When you are doing these things consistently all the time, it's just part of your daily life that you should do every single day. Like it's a part of my life now to get up and do something. It doesn't even have to be big. Actually, I do some very small light exercises, and then I switch it off to a heavy weight training the next day, and then something light, literally just like 100 squats. The next day I'll do like a full session. Then the next day I'll do like 10-minute abs, and then the next day I'll do something heavy again. So it's back and forth. And then when you get into that rhythm of just continuously doing it, you start to realize like, man, I don't care. I don't really care if I look good or not. That's going to come. The problem a lot of time people give up is because they're too invested in trying to look good. And if they don't get the results immediately, they want to give up because they see themselves and like, my God, I'm not changing fast enough. You gave it a week, you know, and that's pretty good too. You know, you can do it for a week. You're like, and then that's another thing. You start feeling complacent because you felt like you've achieved something. You're like, yeah, I've done it for a week. Okay, that should be good. And then you give it another month or two before you get hit it again. And that's not the way to do it. So that's why I always say it's the process that's going to get you there. Not, I don't know. Anyways, that was a lot.
I was really obsessed. Like when you start losing weight, you look at yourself, you're like your body changing. Like wow, I'm actually I realized I had like abs, or I didn't realize I had like this. You look good, you feel more confident, but then you know you're never satisfied.
Yeah.
And then for a while, I got like really not it wasn't too bad, but it was like I was very I was never complacent. Like people would say, dude, you look great. Like stop stressing over stuff. Mm-hmm. You know, enjoy freaking pizza once in a while. And I'd be like, yeah, I know. And then I would, but then I'd feel bad. Like I beat myself over like just eating pizza.
Oh.
And it's so bad. And then eventually I just thought like, oh, I don't like feeling this way. I don't like feeling bad about myself just because I ate something like very minuscule. And it doesn't even do anything considering like I exercise like freaking like 5 times a week, and I pretty much exercise every single day, but I lifted weights like 5 times a week. And then, I was still losing weight, but then it got to the point where like I started fasting and kind of fasting a lot, like more than anybody really should. But fasting is just basically not eating. It's just a bit. And there's a lot of science to it, but in the end, it's basically not eating. And then my girlfriend started to be concerned, and I just, eventually, I don't know. It's just something just clicked where I'm like, I'm okay. I feel okay. And then I gained a little weight, but it wasn't like the bad weight. I'm still very healthy and I still look fine, but I wasn't like as lean as I used to be, which is totally fine too. And what I'm trying to say is I don't think about like looking a certain way anymore. I don't really care because I'm more focused on drawing and stuff now too. But I do enjoy the way I feel after a good workout and a good meal.
So does Nan. So
you start to value that stuff more than just looking a certain way.
Yeah.
So
that's the most important.
Yep. That's the takeaway I got from losing weight.
That's very good.
You feel better. I draw better. Well, I feel like I draw better. I feel like my mind is less. There's more clutter. My hormones, like I don't really get angry for no reason anymore.
Yeah. Says Jet Rains from Cambodia. So does Jibby, by the way. Hey, Jet, it's your biggest fan from Sack Anime, bro, Jordan! What's up, Jordan? I'm sorry, I don't remember Jordan, but it's a familiar name.
Jordan, never mind, I don't know who you are, bro.
My bad, Jordan. Jordan, I'll remember you when I see you.
Who's Jordan?
You understand, it's hard. It's like thousands of people at the freaking convention.
All right, let's look at the comments. We haven't been ignoring comments.
I'm just saying. And let's switch over to my screen. Talk about this. You go ahead and go cover the comments. I'm going to draw a little bit. So we're going to be drawing hands today. Do a hand.
Hands. Going to draw a ham, pig, or hands?
Of course, ham sandwich. What else would we be doing right now? We're just...
Duh. Ham.
Mitten.
Hey, Enzo. Enzo Fernandez. Fernando. I forgot. Damn. I'm sorry. But I know who you are. He's a good buddy.
Okay.
Very supportive. Very good. He's really good. He does like a lot of Dragon Ball, like
Enzo.
Painted.
I think I've come across Enzo.
This stuff is really
Enzo's
good.
My man. We go back.
We are. Okay. Are you both in Japan? You're using Japanese slangs there.
Of course we are.
Oh well, yeah. Yes.
Yes. So desu ne. Yeah.
Still trying to figure out how to enjoy the process of drawings.
Well, here's a go. I was actually thinking about that right now because I haven't sketched in a long time. This sketch is so rough and loose and broken. It's like, looks like I've never drawn before, honestly. That's how I look at it. Done. Not perfect. It's what it is, man. It's my first sketch of look at that, huh? Broken body, broken everything. Doesn't matter. My goal right now is just to freaking get it out of my system. I'm just... You know, that's it.
Same.
Get it out of my system. Start it over.
I don't think I would be like on a roll right now because I remember like that. If you look at one of my drawings, it's a drawing of a female Rathalos from armor from Monster Hunter, and I did not enjoy the process of doing that like at all. I was like, it took me so long, and I just went back and forth where I was, you know, just watching videos, and then I went back to eat, and then I just laid there, and I started playing game, and I went back to draw, and I'm like, I don't like this, but I know I should try to finish it. And then after I did, I built some weird confidence where I'm like, okay, I did that. Like, that was really annoying, but I still did it. And then eventually, it snowballed into actually me liking the stuff I was drawing. I was like, okay, this is pretty cool. I like this. And then more and more, and now I'm actually enjoying the things that I'm drawing again for the first time in a while. And then...
Hell yeah, see?
Yeah.
I was on the same kind of journey at one point when I started doing my dailies. I honestly felt like drawing was just so redundant and a chore because of work.
Exactly.
And I felt like I really didn't need to improve anymore. I'm like, I'm good to go. Until I started doing daily sketches, I was like, you know what? Why don't we approach it from this angle? And it started to become more of a game. Like, oh, wow, this is kind of fun. And then you get the feedback, and that's nice. Get the feedback, and then, like, you want to do it more and more, and it's like, dang, I can't believe I would have missed out on all this. And I always tell that story. I remember telling Sakura Yasin, and I told him way back, he's like, man, you don't sketch anymore? I'm like, no, I don't need to. It's like, and he goes, that's sad. I'm like, what, really? What's sad about that?
Really?
I just don't draw anymore. I don't sketch.
You're sad.
I don't feel the need to. What's? Well, it is kind of sad.
Yeah.
But that's up to me to find out. I'm gonna need to find the purpose to.
Exactly.
To pursue it.
I wasn't feeling it for a while. Mainly because like art isn't my main job either, so I'm like, I don't really have much investment in this. It's whatever. If I do it, I do it. If I don't, I don't. But then I'm like, I actually, you know, I know I like drawing. And then I notice I get like really sad if I like stop drawing for a while because I'm like, this, you know, people are like, yo, your talent is wasting away. I'm like, hey, shut up.
Yeah.
You're right. But shut up. And then eventually I just start to. I get back into it, but now I want to try to stay in it for the long haul. I committed to a YouTube channel where I just
do right. You got a YouTube channel.
Yeah. So, yeah, I'm inspired by like, you know, Didas and stuff doing the little YouTube animations and stuff, and I thought, okay, then I got some fun stories to tell. Let's do this.
Let's do it.
You know what I'm saying? Okay, let's get the comments. Man, I find it hard to gain weight.
Some people say that.
I don't struggle with that. I don't struggle with that at all.
I'll tell you right now. It's a lot. I've heard it from a lot of people. Some people I talk with, they'll be like, man, I'm jealous. I'll switch with you. I'm like, I'll switch with you.
Yeah,
I was gonna say, to gain weight, you just gotta start weight training, lifting weights, push-ups, because when you develop the muscle, it develops a like infrastructure for the fat to lay over, and that's what gives you that form. And then when you stop exercising, then the fat lays over that. And if you're like not consistently, if you're used to doing just like casual push-ups growing up, like playing sports and stuff, run around doing things like that, then you're gonna be building a lot of mass throughout the years. And that's my theory, because I think that's why
people have some crazy metabolisms out there, and I'm jealous.
Yeah.
And for me, I guess like I would have to eat a lot to gain weight. Like I remember when I was trying to gain muscle, I would have to eat 4,000 calories just to gain muscle, because otherwise I was still losing weight. I remember I was testing my body out and I was eating 3,500, so 3,500, and I was still losing weight. I'm like, okay, what's going on? Increase your surplus. So then I did. Cool. And eventually I started gaining weight along with a little fat, which is totally fine. It's totally normal when you're trying to gain mass. But now recently I've been more of a focused on just mobility, because I'm getting older and I just want to feel good, not really particularly mobility. Like look bigger or anything,
right?
So that's been my goal recently. Yeah, for sure a lot of people can relate some way. I don't know, maybe you can, maybe you can't. It's up to you.
It's up to you.
It's up to you.
Maybe you can't.
Maybe you can. Maybe you can't.
I don't know what to do with this foot right here.
You see that foot? Draw it pointing down. Like, oh.
It's broken.
Oh, look, that's good. Oh, you.
What?
Oh, no, never mind. Nothing.
Okay. So it's overlapping. If it's overlapping, God, and then it comes over here, then it has to be like this ish.
What brush do you guys use in paint? I use a dark pencil. That's it.
I use the Jetty Jet brushes. They're custom made brushes that you can get on my store eventually. It's not up.
It's not up. Pay for it. This is a paid sponsorship.
It's never up.
Raid Shadow Legends.
Raid Shadow Legends. I started doing my own personalized brushes after everybody's been bugging me for them, and then when I do them, people got them and then left. It was kind of sad. Like, you guys just left because I offered them for free as a free package reward, like as a dollar tier for my Patreon, and they like let a pan on day. I was like, you guys, come on. You guys
came and snatched everything.
Can't even stay for like two rounds. They're like, it's a little pound all day.
It's okay.
It's all right.
We still love you.
That's part of it. It's part of it. I knew that was going to happen. How do you make custom brushes, bruh? all right, bruh, it's like this though, right, bruh? It'd be like, hold up though. It'd be like,
hold up.
Za 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 za. And you take your lasso tool and you lasso it up and you go to your edit. Ooh. And then you go over here.
Ooh. It'd be like
register material. And you go to image. And it'd be like that though, and that becomes a brush, and then you just like label it and name it, and this is gonna be your next brush. But if you want to do textures and stuff, that's $5. You know what I'm saying? Shit. You think I'm playing? No feet are cursed by nature. No worries, man. Oh, that's so nice. He just made excuses for me. Hell no. I ain't no bitch. I just suck, okay? I'm going to take that loss. I'm going to take that L. I lost.
Nah, bro.
I'm going to offset it. Okay, see, look. Let's do the little tutorial. Leg comes towards us a little bit. We got the knee ball joint. We have the calf structure. We have a little bit of the shin structure, and then we offset it. It goes 1, 2, 3. So then it's slightly showing some semblance. And this is not a foot, by the way. This is like swimming shoes. That's how feet looks. But it's there to serve as a simplified shape placeholder for when I do refine it. And yes. I think I need to draw smaller. These are too. This is way too big. This is way too big. Let's switch it out to Jibby.
What?
Back to you, Jibby.
Oh no! Just kidding. It's fine. Jibberoos. What do you guys want to see?
Jibberoos. I gotta finish. I ate my taco. Man.
Hey, your taco, bro.
Yeah.
What are you doing eating your taco?
I stuffed it down. I didn't realize I ate it so fast. I was trying to get it. I was trying to eat it before I freaking started the show. All right, let's shrink this down. I gotta draw smaller. I was very successful for my last set of sketches, my last Patreon. Oh, and today I am drawing poses for Edis from Final Fantasy VII Remake. I'm playing that right now.
Oh, you still?
Still playing it. Love the game. Love it, love it, love it. It is so fun. So fun.
Quick poses.
It's hella fun. I love
it. My poses are really like quick. I don't really have a.
You got see, Jibby teach you how to simplify it for real. See,
I'm just lazy, dude. There's
see, no other. Jibby, what he does is he cuts through the fat.
Wow. So poetic.
You know what I'm saying?
You know, because I lost weight.
Because you lost weight. And it's like,
yeah,
he just gives us the straight skinny.
That's great. Straight skinny, yes.
They give me the skinny because he cut the fat. No, I'm saying.
Yes,
Jimmy, man, are you high right now?
No, Jimmy, I kind of wish I was, so I have an explanation as to why I am Jibby, the way I am.
You sound high right now. You cut it out.
People always ask me that. Hey, bro, you high? I'm like, no, yeah. I'm just the way I am, dude.
Like, that's a compliment.
I guess.
You got a natural high.
My natural high. Yes. Just drawing my character real quick. I implore you to have like an OC, like it's something to just go back on. Everybody has a dream project, yeah. You know. You remember your wild guy, your little Cambodian guy,
the Cambodian one.
Yeah, and then a lot of people have their own little characters that they want to draw, and that's really okay. Like it's really cool to see because you know it's all your inspiration just mashed up, and then I love seeing that. I love seeing OCs. Like, hey, you know, this is something that I thought up on my own, and I want to show off to the world one day. You know, I'm pretty sure we've all like, oh, I want to make a manga. I want to build something. I want to make a world of my own. You know, like Ross with his Nemo project right now. That's really cool. I like that. And then a lot of people have their own little stuff. This is mine. This is my own stuff. This is my main character, Sun. He's really cool. He's like a little Naruto ripoff. Actually, if you look at his design, like a part of it is actually Ryu from Street Fighter. I've mentioned that before, but it's just kind of funny to see.
You're talking about Sun Wukong?
Sun Wukong, yeah. His name is based off of Sun Wukong.
Oh my god. My character is based off of Sun Wukong.
You biter, bro. Come on. Oh my god, fool. Stop copying my shit, homie. What the hell? Stop copying my shit.
We're gonna get banned.
That's not cool, man.
You better cut it out, man. We're gonna get in trouble with that. No, we actually got minority privileges. It's okay.
Yeah, it's okay. That's what I tell people when I feel like, hey, man, you got white privilege. Or like, okay, at work, this is one guy, and then we were trying to figure out what he was. Like, he's some type of white, but they're like, oh, I think he's Italian. And then the guy's like, oh, I think he looks French. And I went up to him, like, hey, what are you? And he's like, oh, I'm Polish. And the guy's like, oh, you asked him that? I'm like, so? They're like, man, so surprised that I straight up just went up to ask him what he was.
You better stop that, racist.
Damn. Yes, we are both Cambodian.
Can't say that word, rice.
Nei-san Kurofuchi asked, we are both Cambodian. Yes. We're both related. Jet is my older brother.
Yeah. I'm his uncle.
Jet has been my older brother for years now. He just didn't know it.
I didn't know it.
Well, not day.
How many of you guys watch Waterboy? That's a good show. That's a good show to watch.
It's a very good show to watch.
That's a good show to watch.
It's a good movie. What do you mean? It's a good movie.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Uh-huh. I need to figure this pose out. See, I'm just moving this, shifting these hips around. What can work? What can work? What can work? I feel like Aerith is very ethereal, very elegant. So I can't do anything super lewd on her. For her.
Oh, dude. Draw some tiggle bitties on Aerith, though.
Right now? I can't do it right now. I gotta.
Why not?
That's for the fans only. That's for the fans only.
Only? It's for OnlyFans? You got an OnlyFans account?
That's right, right.
Oh, my God.
OnlyFans. Fans only.
Bro. Brother.
なるほどね. I'm from the Asian neighborhood. I'm Filipino.
なるほど, yeah.
Nei-san Korofuji says.
There we go. I'm brown. Yeah. I play guitar. I like to box. I think that's all it takes to be Filipino, right?
Something.
Yeah.
You know, somebody wrote on my comments, popped up and said, "You look Filipino, but you don't have a Filipino accent. What are you?"
You know, no, yeah, say Filipino. You don't have Filipino accent.
Okay, sir.
That's racist. No, it's not. I'm Filipino.
Oh, okay. That's kind of See.
Let's draw big bitties. See, people asking, bro. You gotta give the fans what they want.
Bray, man, I'm gonna get in trouble for that.
Give the fans what they want.
I'm gonna get in trouble.
I guess.
Get in trouble. I don't want no trouble. I'm switching to you.
Okay.
Get over there.
I got a little something something. I got a little something something. Smart. Just drawing some quick poses. This is how like my passes go when I'm animating. So,
right.
Pretty much just. I draw these things where I'm like, it's like a placeholder for the eyes, and then I just kind of go in and draw the eyes. Let's see. Oh, where'd it go? There it is.
Tell him.
Where'd it go?
Tell him.
Ooh, tell him.
Ooh.
Ooh.
Tell him.
All right. So, see, my eyes are really simple. Ooh. I don't really. They're just like, whoa. I should erase that completely. See, I'm draw a quick face. Let's draw a quick face. Draw very simple, no detail needed. Just like he's looking up.
Yeah.
Let's draw the mouth. It's like closed. Bam. That's all you need. And then you just I need to get my pivot in the arm right. Whoa. For his headband. Oh wait. And whoa. Bam. Okay, that's a little off, but
that's a lot of bams.
And it's whatever.
Slow down with that bam, boy.
Bam. Then I draw the hair.
Slow it up with that bam.
Hair.
You get some seizures and wanna give a little kid seizures. You gotta stop with that bam, though.
Bam.
What? He said bam again.
Bam. They're probably looking at it like, oh, this is kind of ugly. And I know. Slap, slap. It's okay.
Slap, slap.
It's okay. It's okay if it's ugly.
No, Loaf was right. He sure was.
About what?
Don't even know.
Loaf was right, though.
He was right.
So, say I go in. Let's fix this a little bit. So yeah, are you still? Is it on my screen? No, it's still on my screen. Yeah. All right, just keep it like that. Keep it like that.
It's on your screen, yeah. Oh yeah.
Right now, I'm just drawing quick poses. Some quick. Quickly, quick poses. I got this one over here. And I got this one over here.
Do you guys know who Randy Savage is?
Okay, no. Who Randy Savage? What is a Randy Savage?
What is
a Randy Savage?
That's how old I am, man. When I was a little kid watching Saturday TV in the morning, WWF would come on, and then Randy Savage would come on. Oh, yeah.
Tell us more, Grandpa.
Randy Savage would sell us some Slim Jims on TV. Right in the middle of my cartoon. This dude would come on. Slim Jim. Oh, yeah. That's pretty much it.
All right. So we got a question. Again, by...
Then you guys know what a Slim Jim is.
It says, what are your inspirations?
I'm not trying to.
I think this guy is pretty earnest, so let's give him an actual answer. Nah, fool, I don't have any inspiration. I think on the website all day. Little Ricky is my inspiration, fool. I know. let's see. Isn't Joji Filipino? No, he's like white and Japanese. What even? Okay, so.
Who are you, Ty?
All right, let's see. What are your inspirations? You want me to go first? I'll go first.
Oh, yeah.
By my inspiration. All right.
Who are your inspirations, Jibby?
My inspirations, you know, Yo Yoshinari, my boy, obviously.
Yoshinari, gotcha.
Yoshinari. He's the GOAT.
He's the GOAT.
He's the animator. He's an illustrator. He's a character designer.
Just call him.
Might know him from the mech designer for Gurren Lagann. He directed Little Witch Academia. He did background design for Kill la Kill.
Yeah.
He worked on like a lot of anime. He worked on Evangelion.
Oh yeah, that's good.
Like Gainax stuff. You know what I'm saying?
That's good.
Yeah. He's really, really good though.
Oh yeah.
Really
good. I call him the anime goat.
The goat. Yes. He is really good.
He has it.
What about you, Jet? You're from a different time. Who's
my time? I like Bob Ross. See. I don't know, man. I don't know. I have inspirations all over the place.
Come on, tell us.
You said you like
Evangelion, right?
Well, but I mean, in terms of artists, I would say there's Ray, and then there's Ray.
Ray underscore 17.
Yes. That's the one. And then the other one is Krenz. Both are Chinese.
Krenz Kushar.
The one's Taiwanese. Yes. They might both be Taiwanese. I'm sorry, you guys, if I screwed that up. You guys are
Krenz Kushar?
Yeah, yes. Krenz Kushar. I don't want to screw that one up.
Oh, he's really good. That guy. I love that guy. It's amazing.
Love those guys.
Let's ask the chat, what are their inspirations? Are you guys like into anime, into more illustration, like Dave Raposa type of things? Or they're like, you know, we're probably into anime if they're on your stream, you know, or if they're fans of mine, because I only ever draw anime. But
yeah,
I'm into a lot of anime. You can tell, like, my stuff is very simplified, so I have a more animated approach or inspirations when it comes to a lot of things.
Yeah.
And I think that's okay. I like it. Right. I enjoy it. It gets to the point.
Okay.
I like movement. I like expressions. I like characters and all that jazz. So.
You got some jazz going on here.
All that jazz. Yes.
The K-pop.
Jar with Jazza. This one. Yes. No, I'm just kidding. No. Can I show some of my animations? Oh, dude, it's still buggy on my side. I don't think they can see it.
Why not?
Is the screen blurry for you guys, or is it just my thing acting up?
I think it's blurry.
Oh, man, that's bad.
I'll switch to mine. Don't worry. Still working on these sketches here. These doo-doo sketches. How's your screen now?
Still looks kind of weird. Better.
Okay, how's everybody doing? You guys hanging in there? We got this show going on. We got the 2 hours. What? We've been on for 2 hours? Oh, that's
no.
That's too long.
I don't think so.
No, it's too long.
Was it 2 hours?
I think it's been 2 hours, you guys.
No.
That has been a. What? I did two sketches.
You see? Yeah, I did two sketches too. That's all I did. I didn't do anything.
People do full on illustrations. Come on.
That was not 2 hours. I feel like I was had the thing.
That was 2 hours, man. That was 2 hours. Linear art or just colorful art? Don't use line. What do you prefer? Why? Marcho Vitromil asks. Well, Joy Aktosh says it's been. Oh, I think I know what it is. I see now. It's only been an hour. It says 2 hours,
dude.
Because no, it's because OBS. I had it streaming already before it was going live. You actually have to hit the stream button now. They have a new method.
So. Dude, it's so blurry though, bro. They can't see my drawings.
I don't know what to tell you, dog.
Fix it.
No, you can't fix it.
God,
it's your fault.
All right.
Chibi.
That's totally fine. You don't have to see my drawings.
Linear art or just colorful art? Don't use line. Ah, you mean like painterly? I say either way you choose. Either way, it's going to work out in the end. In the end, you find each other in the middle. I'll do a little diagram. Here's a diagram, ready? It goes like this. It goes, we have the line army. And then we have the paint gang, line army. And what ends up happening is people who swear by line gang, line army, they draw more comic-y style, more anime, and they get really good. And like, oh my God, I need to start incorporating color. I need to start painting. And they're like trying to figure out, man, I need to get really good. Okay, I'm getting good at painting. I suck at painting, but I'm really strong. So it starts to become like this. I'm really strong. The more I do it, it's like this. You get this nice triangle like that. And it starts and then you start reaching over there for that paint, and then he starts getting this triangle slope here. So that's the strength. You have plenty of experience in the line. I could have done that better. Paint gang, same thing. It goes the other way, and there's this overlap that goes like this.
Paint gang.
And then eventually, they start to get that experience. But in the end, they start to meet in the middle. If you're starting from paint gang, you're gonna lack on a lot of line and structure. That's why you're gonna miss out on a lot of underdrawing and draftsmanship. But your ability to lay down color and light is very strong immediately. But to a line person, you can see all the flaws. You're like, man, that thing's really, really broken. There's a lot of just issues. You got like an X-ray vision. And then to a paint gang, you might look at it and be like, man, there's no life in that drawing. It's so flat. It looks so fake and stale. But then there's that happy in between. And eventually, it'll just cancel each other out. You're just going to be so good to the point where they start to do this. The end.
The end.
That's life.
That is life.
And it doesn't matter which side you choose.
It does not. Actually, it kind of does.
Yeah, you have to be floor gang at the end.
Floor gang!
It matters depending on what you want to do. It is. You want to be a painter, you paint. This is pretty simple. You want to animate, you draw lines. That's also very simple.
Yeah, and I mean, like, I look at it like this. For me, I went the line route, and I was scared of color. I was scared of paint.
You went the line route?
Yeah, and then you start to learn how to render out forms and shapes based off the lines. And then you start to incorporate more and more and more of those painting techniques. And then you hit puberty eventually, someday. And then you get good. And then you start eating sushi and watching anime.
Yes.
Yeah. All right, let's get another sketch in before this turns into like a crazy
long.
Crazy long random stream that has nothing to do with this Aerith story.
I'm sad. My thing is very blurry. I can't see my drawing. Okay, I just did a couple of poses.
We're going to draw a head here. We're going to draw a skull structure here. Okay. Skull structure here. All right, follow along now. Follow along. Try to use as little as line. That didn't sound right. Try to use
as little as lines.
As little as lines. Trying to say, man. Try to use as little lines possible. I think that's what I'm trying to say.
I think so.
Try to draw these shapes rudimentary, simplified, and also loosely. Okay. Try to draw these simplified organic shapes to represent each mass of volume of the anatomy. So this is going to be like the rib cage, see? So that's going to be that. But I'm not concerned with actual cage muscles and turns and stuff. Actually, these little lumps and stuff, I'm not thinking about it. I'm not concerned about fixing them. I'm just going to use that as my launching pad. Okay? And I'm drawing past these shapes in order to get these shapes to overlap.
Yes.
And they're like jigsaw puzzles. Okay? All right, so let's draw the next structure. I'm going to draw the shoulder right here. See that? That's a shoulder. We could start it over here. Maybe not too close to the head. Okay, let's do that shoulder right there. Now, if that's the shoulder, then where the arm at? It's going to be right here.
Where the arm at?
See that? Just like that. And then we just draw the other section of the arm like that. Okay, we have this forearm muscles, the bend, and we could put this hand right about here like this. We can just do it at an angle like this. And it was just this big old triangular shape here.
Mm-hmm.
Now, just to make things more visible, we'll clear it up a bit here. So now we got this gesture where she's lifting up her shoulder up. Now, what we're going to do with the other arm is we're going to just draw another shoulder. Welcome. Oh, reconnected successful. That's great. That's great. Okay, so I'm starting and sensual and intimate. Let's do the other arm right here like this. And like that. And voila. So we got this hand here. Hand here. Like that. Slam, slam. Maybe she's like stroking her hair away with that arm right there. All snuggly and soft, because that's who Aerith is. It's actually more, actually she's the softest character. It's like Tifa. Tifa's so soft, passive. I was like, that's not the character I expected when I seen the pictures growing up.
She's soft.
Yeah, she's not very like spicy. The spicy one's Jesse. Like, I was so confused.
She feels soft.
Most likely.
She feels soft, man.
Possibly.
Yummy. I had a big crush on Tifa as a kid.
Yeah.
Yeah. I remember seeing her in the Advent Children movie, and I'm like, oh my god.
Yeah.
I don't know. My balls didn't drop yet, so it was like, it got me feeling some type of way, though. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. It's a very confusing feeling.
I don't know. I like girls. I think I do now.
Yeah, I would get dizzy. I just like end up on the floor, like passed out. Like what happened? It's like, man, I saw another girl.
<That's> stupid.
Damn. That's why girls got them cooties.
Girls got cooties. Stay with them.
Girls got them cooties. Cause it rhymes with booty.
It's true though.
Make sure to erase this episode after we're done.
That's fine.
Shall we erase it? I've been on the internet for too long. I don't know what I've been saying. But don't no one care about the artists.
No one care about the artists.
Don't care.
Artists.
There we go. This is something I'm feeling. I'm feeling like she's got the hand right here, kind of following that leg. This is going to be the balance. She's got that.
Feeling it.
Yeah.
Can you feel it now? Perhaps.
Yeah. I mean, slap to a Slim Jim. Oh, yeah. Slam you. Okay, brother.
Yes, brother.
That's how they used to call each other in the wrestling world. They used to always call each other brother. Listen here, brother. Yeah. Listen here, brother.
You watch a lot of wrestling growing up?
Oh yeah.
Back during the
Hulk Hogan. Call me Hulk Hogan.
I'm gonna do just finish this up real quick.
Yeah, I watched a lot. All right, let's try one more. Well, let's go back to your screen real quick. There you go.
It's so blurry. You shouldn't.
Yours is making a lot more sense than mine.
Is it?
Yeah, it's fine. It looks good.
Try using
24. What's up, 24? 24, you made it. You finally made it. Congratulations. I like Tifa too.
Still very blurry. Go back. Let's go back. It's embarrassing.
It's fine.
No.
It's fine.
No, it's super blurry.
It's fine. Maybe
it's just, is it a clip studio?
It's fine.
It's blurry.
We're gonna end this show. We can keep that up. We're gonna end it up right now. We're gonna end it in like 5 minutes.
No. No papa.
One show what?
It's okay. Why are you not feeling this stream?
No, I'm feeling it. I just don't want it to go too long. That's the goal.
Yeah, that's true.
See? Restraint.
That is the end goal.
You gotta have restraint. Gotta learn that. Another great trait or characteristic to try to achieve in life is restraint. I have none. I have none. None.
I always want things like right now, you know? It's just like...
Well, that's one thing, yes, for sure. That's one thing. And then the other one is just I always overindulge. I'm like a glutton.
Yeah.
I'm a gluttonous. Same. There's never enough. So, like, if I draw, I say, okay, 1 hour, 6 hours later.
Honestly, it doesn't even make me better. I'm just, like, doing it because I feel like I think it does. But if I just kind of, like, go off of it and come back, I'm, you know, I still improve just the same.
Yeah, so. I notice a lot of a lot of the great, more consistent, more prolific artists out there are very good at managing time and constraint. Like, they know how to just, like, knock some out, move on, knock some out, move on. It's okay. It's okay. Look, it's broken, but it's fine. We'll do something else. It's fine.
Broken.
It's freaking fine. It doesn't matter. Okay? Yes. You can pick at it all you want, but it doesn't matter when I'm the shit. And I did 3,000 illustrations. I'm the shit. After I finished 3,000, you still stuck on that second one?
You like Popeye's chicken.
That's sad for you. So, like, that's what I'm saying. Like, you know, sometimes people like to complain and nitpick, you know, and it's a good to a degree.
To a degree.
Especially if you're the one who's drawing your drawing. You're nitpicking your own art. That's fun. But to a degree. You have people out there who are producing so much because they're not nitpicky that they're able to improve so much better and faster because that's... They're using the mistakes as
fuel.
They're learning from it.
They're learning. Yes, it's like you can go back and fix all the mistakes, or you can try not to make the same mistake in the next illustration. You know?
Yeah. You don't want to waste time just fixing every single mistake. You're not. You're wasting time.
Just post it and then move on, brother.
Stop worrying about that mistake. That mistake's gonna fix itself.
Yes,
it's gonna fix itself in the long run. The long run is your ability, your skill to see the things that you're doing wrong, and that faster. That's why daily sketches work so well.
Yes,
every single day.
Very much so. Agree.
You stuck fixing one thing. You can spend like 100 freaking hours on one drawing, or you can spend 100 hours producing 20 drawings. I think the amount you will learn out of the quantity versus quality is much more valuable. But that again, it becomes that spectrum that you choose. You like quality over quantity? That's fine. You like spending hours and days on one piece and mastering that one piece? That can be your thing. It's not that it's a wrong thing. That can be you. Be you.
We all learn differently.
Our bodies
work differently. You know, some of us has faster metabolisms. Some of us have slower ones. And it's like, it really depends on what works for you, man. And then...
No, we don't. We're all the same. We're all exactly the same.
Yeah, we're all the same.
We're all a bunch of Jimmies. We're all a bunch of Jimmies out here.
Some normal schmo. Nothing. Nothing to look at, you guys.
Schmo? There's also Render Gang. That's what we just mentioned. Yeah, Render Gang. There is Render Gang.
Mm-hmm.
There's Render Gang. You're absolutely right.
Yep.
Render Gang.
I'm not really trying like to go really detailed. I'm just going to finish up these lines. Like very loose. I'm not. This just would be like my second pass. Or this is a pass I would use for animation or something. And then I'll just throw in some colors in it. Yeah. Nothing too fancy, y'all. Say, Carrera said, you can only improve until a certain point every day. Drawing more than that won't make you improve, but it's still fun, though. Yeah, very, very much so. I agree. I wouldn't deny that, like, at all. So, just stick to it. Enjoy the process. Very much so enjoy the process. And then, I'm zooming in really close.
Enjoy the process.
Enjoy the process, guys.
I don't enjoy the process right now. I'm like stressing out right now. I'm like, oh my god.
Really?
What am I doing?
Come on, Mujet. Enjoy the process. Can't tell people that and then start stressing out. Brother, what is wrong with
you? No, we all go through that. I go through that 100%. Don't enjoy it. Don't enjoy sometimes. Just like, man, what the hell am I doing? Kicking my ass right now. Because you're trying to do something. And right now, I'm trying to do like a sitting pose. Let's go over here, switch over to men. Let's knock this out. Let's knock this out right now. Okay, let's knock this out. Okay. All right, so let's try to do things simplified because I was trying to do arms, but sitting. I was like, okay, what we can do is simplify it again like we did. How about that, huh? Jelly beans. Mm-hmm. You know how to draw a jelly bean?
What is it?
Like jelly beans.
The torso?
Yeah. Draw a jelly bean.
What are you talking about?
Torso.
Oh. Torso?
Yeah.
Yes.
Let's not even draw the neck. See? Let's remove that neck shape. So we got the head. Okay. Okay, now let's draw some jelly beans for the torso. Jelly beans. Don't make the jelly beans too hairy. Don't make it too hairy. But definitely draw the jelly bean. And then we can do one of the legs right over here. Like this. We'll draw a circle. Can you draw a circle? I can do a circle. Let's do a line for the leg. Oh. How about that? And then we can just attach the muscles to that.
Yes.
See that?
Yeah. Yeah, see? Yeah.
So I'm trying to make the one leg cross over the other. That's why it's tricking me out. And now, before we draw the other leg, how would we do this? Like this. And then we have this leg here like this. Oh! And then you can erase out the guidelines. Erase it out. So I'll be taking this into multiple passes. This is their first pass. Get to adding the clothing, and then I'm going to be cleaning it up. And then from there, it should be done. This is the bottom of the thigh.
Should be done.
Now I'm having fun, see? See? Simplifying it. Knowing the process is fun. Sometimes being lost is also fun, but most of the times stressful AF.
Don't tell them that. It's not fun.
It's not fun.
It's terrible.
It's painful to be lost. I hate being lost. Who likes being lost? I don't like being lost.
I hate being lost.
But you need to be lost before you can be found.
I've never heard that one. You need to be lost to be found. You need to be lost when you're found. Like
you almost got it.
In the lost and found.
But then, do you want him to do you so much you can do anything? You want him to do you so much you can do anything? You wanted him to do you so much you could do anything. For some people. I mean, that shouldn't be a motivating factor, but to some it is. Just search that up on Google. It's a fine meme. This is a fine one. It's aged well. This is from like freaking early 90s, man. This kid's like my age. He's like my age.
Really?
Yes. You wanted him to do you so much you could do anything? He's so proud of himself. He's like, I got it. I still got it. You know, seeing kids, they're like, you know, kids asked to say the darndest thing type of things type of show.
Mm-hmm.
And he just like feels so proud because he like knocked it out. He's like, yes. This is so
sick. I've seen that.
Child, you are a legend. Have you guys seen that one? I saw that vid. Link it. I don't remember the title of it. I just said it. Have you ever wanted him to do you so much you can do anything? Yeah, do it. Have you wanted him to do so much you can do anything? Damn, man. He's my age. He's like showing all his friends, hey, yo, that was me. Hey, Ena Kulot, welcome. You're late. We have a couple more minutes on the show, and then we'll be wrapping it up. But we're glad you can join at this hour. I'm so sorry. Have you... Wasas, I'm Albert something from the cult. Huh? Albert something from the cult. Is that somebody's name, right? Okay. I assume. Hey.
Yes.
Hip. Zip. Zip. Hip. 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 So problem with this right now, I'm feeling right now with these is the lines are too thick right now. I'm saying. So maybe shrinking the line a little bit. How are you doing over there? I'm gonna go back to you.
No. It's blank.
If you want to do anything. No. You wanted him to do you so much. You could do anything. That's what the kid said. He's a legend. He's like top 10 most famous memes to ever exist, ever. He's more famous than like that little kazoo kid. Actually, Kazoo's pretty iconic. He's got a whole TV series based off of him, so you can't only can beat that.
Mm-hmm.
That's power.
That is power.
You know the Kazoo kid?
No.
Well, you don't know the Kazoo kid. Okay.
Alright.
I couldn't have said it better myself. If so. Yeah, your screen is very clear now. Wow, look at those lines. When did you lay those down?
Sweet. Just now. I did two poses, actually.
Sweet baby Ray's barbecue.
I'm just going to do some quick shell shading and some loose lines. And bada boop, bada oopsie. Bada boop, bada boop, beep.
Bada boop, boop. Beep. Hey.
It's not a big deal. It's just my line of approach, you know what I'm saying? I'm thirsty.
I want something to drink. Okay, I'm doing one more loose sketchy sketch and then we'll just end this stream right there and then, okay? I think
it's yeah, great. Let me finish the shell shading and then
no, we're gonna finish no shell shading. You go as
quick.
Look,
no.
Give me look, I'll be doing
it'll take me like 5 minutes, okay?
Yeah, no, I'm gonna draw for another 5-10 minutes and then we'll see where we are. And by that time, I hope you guys get your last questions in. Because we about to end this stream. I want this stream to be like another 2-3 hours. I hate that.
Bada-boo.
You know, when you see a bunch of streams stacked together that are like each 3 hours long, it's like, you're lazy. You're so lazy. You can't even make these episodes like 10 minutes and edit it? No. All you do is live stream. Crazy.
We call you lazy.
Crazy.
We call
No!
No.
No!
Who calling you lazy, bro? But catch these hands. Call you lazy, though.
You say lazy, though.
My lines colors are ugly.
Look like Ryu with a sword.
Exactly, you know what I'm saying? You know what
He's straight up Larry with a sword.
Straight up Ryu with a cape and a sword. How do you these lines? They looking okay?
Yeah, it's clean. It's clean.
It's clean. It's clean, though.
I got no excuses. I got no excuses.
No excuses, though.
No excuses.
All no right. Sushi.
Keep going, man.
Sushi.
I'm gonna try one more sketch, okay?
Okay.
This is it. This is the one. This is the sketch to end them all. The one to end all sketches. The sketch of the sketches. Dare I say.
Is there like a faster way to color these things? I don't know.
What? Yes, there is. You're actually doing it the slow way. Jimmy, stop it.
What do I do?
Stop. Get some help.
No.
You gotta take
That's what my mom told me.
Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah, you get your paint bucket tool. Just get your paint bucket tool, man. Just get your paint bucket tool. Let me show you how to do this.
I was about to do. Okay, I'm just about to get the outlines and then I got
Not like that. Not like that. That's how the old school do it. Let me show you how the pros do it, okay? Alright, chillin'. Alright, chillin'. Take the paint bucket tool. What is that? You call that a paint bucket? Jimmy. Go to your lines. Where are your lines at?
But my lines aren't closed.
I don't care. Open. It don't matter. Clip Studio don't. Don't GAF. They don't. They don't care. They don't care. They don't care about your feelings. They just do it. You don't have to close.
What do you want?
Get your lines. Click on your lines. Line layer. Okay. Click on the line layer.
Set
that as a reference layer. That's that little tower with the lights coming out of it next to the
Set as reference layer. Okay.
Yeah. Now come back down to the color flat layer.
Okay. Okay.
Now are you gonna have multiple colors in that layer?
Yes.
Okay. So now you're gonna go to the paint bucket tool.
All right.
Let me see the properties. Open that up so your brushes move out of the way a little bit. Stretch it out so I can see this, because I can't see the properties. Area scale. Whoa. I mean vertically. Sorry.
What are you talking
Is that everything? Because I see area scale and I see move it down.
Area.
All right. That's everything. Okay. Close gap right there. It says close gap right there. Turn up. It's so pixely.
Yeah. All right. I see it. Yeah. All right.
Close gap. All the way. All right. Some of your holes are a little bit too big, so what you're gonna take the ink brush and then
close it.
Close it with your ink brush first.
All right.
It doesn't have to be all the holes, just some. Yeah, like take that. Yeah. Just. And then the big ones, the biggest ones, the biggest of the big. Close it with the ink, and then use the paintbrush bucket, and then fill it.
Oh, no way.
Damn, see what it do.
Nope.
No, you missed it. You missed the... What?
I did it wrong. Let's do this again. All right.
If you guys are seeing what I'm seeing, I'm seeing distortion, but I'm trying to see through the glass, the looking glass right now. I'm trying to see through this. Come on, get that paint bucket. Get on it. Get back onto that layer. Okay, now. Okay.
I don't think. No,
there's a big
right.
ass. There's a big ass hole in his shoe. Nick, I told you, get your ink brush. Fill it out. Yeah. What the hell, man? Yeah.
But it's on the wrong layer though. How do I make it?
Well, go back down. Go to line layer. Yeah. Oh, I know. Okay, go to paint bucket again. Go to paint bucket.
Okay.
Oh man, it's so pixelated because it's like your lines are all stacked. Okay, look, now there's a fill mode in your properties that says refer to layer reference layer. You see that? you got the matrix going on. You see it on the paint bucket. Go left.
Mm-hmm. And then go left.
Yeah, where it says fill mode, there's like four different fill modes.
You see them? I don't see it.
There is. You have to use your eyeballs.
I don't see it.
Okay, let me look at my paint bucket too. Okay. Okay, so it's right underneath area scaling. You have to open it up a bit. Underneath area scaling. Stretch it down.
Prefer multiple?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, roll it down a bit. Yeah. There we go. Not too much. That's a little, you don't need all that space. Actually.
Let me see.
Okay. Right there.
Refer multiple, is it?
No, refer. It's the second one. Reference layer. That one.
What are you down? Talking about?
No, down. You see the pictures of the different paint buckets? There's four paint buckets. Down. Four paint buckets. Yeah. Now, it's the second one. Yeah, reference layer. Oh. Reference layer one. Clicked it?
There we go.
Yeah, and is the left box checked too? That says multiple.
Yeah.
Okay, good. Now
let's try it.
Damn, oh, see what it do.
Oh snap.
Damn. Yeah. No day. So obviously the big holes you want to, my God.
No, I see it.
It's so fragmented. It's like,
dude, this is stop like recording.
This is like Call of Duty 2007.
It's because you're recording, dude. It's because you recording. Dope.
Okay, so that's how you do it. You feeling it? You feeling it now? Okay, all right.
Wow.
So you can save yourself a little bit of time now. And if it doesn't fill it up all the way,
wrong my whole life. Oh, that's fine. I don't really care.
Does it work? If it works,
it works. Good. Fine, dude. Shoot.
All right. Let's see what the kids are saying. Jet, just have him look at your screen. LMAO. He can't. It's delayed. And if I try to explain things to him, he'd be
having. I'm stupid.
He'd have. Yeah, what? He'd be traveling back in time. and then he'd report back to me in the future. It'd just be a mess. We lose either way.
We lose.
Either I'm trying way. To use my like intuition, my intuition skills. See, Clip Studio has been ingrained into my mind's eye, so like I'm not even looking. My eyes are closed as I talk to him.
For real.
Oh my God! Finally, it looks beautiful now. It's so crispy. It's so clean.
Crispy. Okay, the skin's kind of like, ugly.
It's like a really nice. It's nice, nice. Okay.
Thank you.
I'm saying like there's no distortion at all, but I think yeah, it's one of those things like you know when you watch bad latency streaming, which is what we're doing, it slowly retains the pixelations, and it starts to distort over each other. Okay. I think that's what yeah. Okay, kids, I hope you guys learned a little something about what he just did with his.
Yes, learn
with his LSD learn. Clip Studio. Yeah, it doesn't hit all those little pockets, but you can always go through that. And
that's okay. That's okay.
And fill it up.
That's okay. All right, we got a couple drawings in.
That's all right. 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 Okay. Yeah. Let me do a little sketch. Real quick.
Wait, let me finish this. Let me try with the other one real quick.
Yeah, we're gonna keep you on here because nice and clean.
Bada boop.
Thank you, Carrera. It was very useful. I don't want him to be going back in time. I thought about getting to that teleportation machine, but I said no. I ain't no biscuit.
What do you plan on doing after this?
Probably eat another taco, probably. See about that Sajo. Homemade tacos, by the way.
Tacos. Oh, homemade tacos. You know what's going in your taco then.
We grilling it all up. We grilling that chicken. We season it right. We get that avocado. Then we get that four cheeses. Then we like sprinkle it. Be like,
Haven't tried. Try with the other one. Like, some. For real.
Zum 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 That's how you eat and sleep at the same time. Have you ever wanted him to do so much you could do anything?
Boop, boop.
You got a hole. You got to fill it with an ink brush first. You got anything?
I got anything first.
You just put it down in his shorts. Jimmy, don't disappoint me.
Boop. Boop. Let's get this
good
in.
Good job, boy.
Boop. Boop.
Wow, you could be the best.
I'm gonna get.
You could be the best.
I'm gonna get.
All right. Let me switch it on over here.
Boop.
Zap. Zow. Okay. Just.
Get some of that white in here.
Jibby.
Yes, pose.
I moved you out of the way. I'm gonna try to do this pose real quick here. Okay. So we're gonna hit this shape here. Now I like to draw the head at an angle. That already gives us a little bit of gesture. Straight up and down is fine. You wanna start up? But with that slight shift in the angle, we already can assume that there is a gesture and some dynamic pose. I always like to follow with the line of the shoulder line. Then, to keep things simple, again, we can just draw the shape of the torso like this. We can draw it like this too. Draw the main shapes first, like this. We don't have to draw the jelly bean. This reminds me more of the Andrew Loomis technique.
What is a jelly bean? I want some jelly beans.
I don't think kids eat jelly beans nowadays. I keep saying this word jelly bean. Like, what do you keep? Who eats beans? Eat a jelly bean? What are you talking?
Baboo? Better bat. I'm like dancing all over the page like a bat bat.
Yes, you're using the force very well, my son. You've learned well. You have learned well, Padawan. You have learned the way of the Jedi. Bada boom. Bap.
Bada. It's a Jedi.
Blip. Zap. Zoink. Zoom. Blip.
Blip. Blip. Hey. Blip. Blip. Zoink. Zoom. Hear that, kids? I wonder who's still here. It was just like...
Nobody's here. Nobody is here.
Deuces.
T said... Peace.
I feel like that can be a little bit more.
Yep. Blip, 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 blip. I feel like my arm's a little bit too big. I want to show the arch of the side here. So let's just keep it along this area here. Again, anytime I have a little difficulty figuring something out, I always try to take a step back and try to simplify it just a little. Just a little bit. You know? That's why I admire Jibby's approach a lot. He keeps it very,
very freaking nice, though.
Very focused. He doesn't worry about all these shapes and stuff. It's like, why you worry about muscles and stuff? Just arm.
For real though, just worry more about
two shapes. Two line. Okay, line.
Two line.
Two line. 1, 2. That's way too low. Bend. Elbow. Forearm. other forearm. Hand. Sometimes you do a stick figure hand. You ever heard a stick figure hand? I heard a stick figure hand. I heard a stick figures, but have you heard a stick figure hand?
Yes.
Have you heard a stick figure hand?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5
No matter how many times you say it, I don't know what you're talking about. What are you saying?
What are you saying, dude? What the hell wrong with you?
Explain it. Stick figure hand.
Stick figure hand.
Stick figure hand. And then boobs. And then boobs. Okay, look, listen. The boobs, don't complicate it, okay? Don't complicate it with the circle. Don't complicate it with the nipples. Don't complicate it with the boob. Just, honestly, just draw a line. That's boob! Solved. That's boob. That's boob number one. Boob number two is, remember, we don't want circles. We want J's. It's like Jetty Jets. But unless it's being compressed or it's floating. So we can have C's. We can have some C's. So, I'm confused, Mr. Jet. You're telling me draw J's, now you're telling me draw C's. You came to the wrong show. Oh, you thought you was going to learn something today?
What are you, stupid?
You may have lost a few brain cells in this process.
It's true.
The losing the brain cells. All right, look, I've been teasing with these freaking... I always do this. I always do a bunch of poses.
Okay.
Let it bounce all day. What?
Got a comment saying, are you guys okay? We're fine. Oh, we're just great. Right now.
We're not fine. We're great. We is great. That's all I gotta say.
Are you guys? I just imagine the concern of seeing the freaking stream. Like, what the? Okay. Okay.
All right.
People are funny.
Now, I'm not drawing hair and stuff because I'm not quite sure how her hair works. That's the problem. I don't want to go to looking for the references in the middle of a stream. Even though I'm like, I can switch off to Jibby and do it, but it's like, why would I do that to you? I got a didn't work. She has like a big old ponytail. But I was trying to say, I've been teasing a lot with these poses without faces. It's like, give me a face. When we gonna give a face?
You do not draw faces. Draw a face. Draw a face, though.
Yeah. Somebody. By the way, I got hired by Clip Studio. I'm just saying, it's kind of funny. This is the guy they want.
For real?
Yeah.
What do they want you to do?
Yeah, they want me to be their main spokesman of every single product they ever sell in the future, for everything that they ever do, for all of it, every item that they put out.
If you turn,
yeah.
So you get free stuff?
No, I don't know. No. I'm in the works right now. I'm just doing like I'm handling a lot of their. Oh shit! It's the NDA. I can't really talk. Can't even talk, but I can. I'm guessing we're gonna be doing tutorials for them some way somehow. But
okay.
I'll tell you about it afterwards. Just hopefully they don't. They already obviously discovered me through my YouTube. So it's like, you guys know what you signed up for, right?
All right, I'm done.
You done?
I'm done.
You done? I'm not even sure if that's her hair, but. Oh, wow. Looks like sprites for a video game. Immediately ready to play. I'm ready to play. Kickstarter right now. There's 30,000. Here's 30,000 for you. Now I want the game. Hey, what's up, Jimbitakanker? That's an odd name. I'm trying to pronounce it the best I can. How are you doing? Jimbit ain't core. Hi.
Hi. Jimbitakanker?
Soak somebody.
What? Jimbit.
Ayana said, that's a boob. Are you guys actually brothers?
Yes.
We go way back. We go towards lineage. That's like how, that's how much of brothers we were. We have lineage, see.
You know lineage?
Yeah.
You know lineage though?
So I'm Cambodian and so is Jibby. We actually come from the same, our family actually come from the same parts.
Towns. The same town.
Towns, like my mom and your mom.
We immigrate. Our families immigrated here at the exact same time too.
Yeah, so it's kind of strange, and it's like, yeah, we might be related down the line. Like pretty sure if you go
we
back.
We honestly kind of look the same too.
Yeah, we sound the same. So I don't. Maybe all Cambodians sound the same. I don't think so. I have plenty.
There's no way to track our family history because a lot of stuff happened during the war. You know, so
yeah,
it's just kind of
It's weird too, cause your birthday's around my birthday, and then we both draw, and then I remember Cynix is the one who introduced me to Jimmy, and I was like, he was like, yeah man, he's like Little Jet, he sounds like you. I'm like, what are you talking about? Let me see this kid. I was like, oh shit, it's Little Jet, it's little me but big me.
We're on the same size. Yeah.
We're about the same size. I think you're taller than me.
5'10"? 5'11"?
You're taller than me. Ah! Carrera, I learned a lot. I'm getting an industry job now with this knowledge.
Wow.
Very good.
Jimmy Yin, I think. Yes.
Glad I can help. I think we have the same last name, too. Well, Yin is not your other last name. Was it? Do you have another last name?
Sin, my mom's last name.
Yeah, my last name was initially Sin too. I don't know why.
That's crazy, dude. Oh my!
It's now my middle name. We switched it over to my dad's name. And it's from my mom's lineage, so we probably could be related, dude. It's weird. But a lot of Cambodians I meet do have similarities between each other. Like I know Didas sounds similar to one of my friends here, but not like you. And then I have like another friend that's Cambodian who sounds like somebody else. So, you know, yes. it's just the gene pools. We're like, sure, within the same genes. Zucchini juice. Everybody, we have to, we're going to wrap it up. We're going to wrap it up now for you today, tonight.
Yeah. Oh, back when he had another. I was another Cynix guy. I don't think I ever had a Cynix style. It's weird. I think he's talking about Raphael.
Yeah.
I appreciate like Cynix's stuff, but then I just never flowed to like for me anyways. I always leaned more towards
Skull Jet. Chimes says Clip Studio is a superior art tool. Can't change my mind. I agree.
Zucchini Juice says the stream has a 5-minute delay.
5 minutes? Woo! That's a lot of delay, actually.
That's the animator guy. I forgot it. Kenny, yeah.
Alright, so I just gotta say this was a good time, Jibby. Thanks for being on the show. Zucchini says also hi, Jibby. Good to have you on, and we'll do this again sometime soon. Hopefully soon.
Later. I'm feeling pretty good, so don't hold on me, cause I'm saying.
Yeah, I really gotta finish this. don't know if I'm happy with. I'm happy with like maybe two of these.
No, no problemo. No problemo. Do your thing, Jelly Bean.
Do your thing. Stream is on time for me. No issue. CT Chrysler. Oh no.
CT Bresler.
Man, it was so sad too. I wish this year was just, man. Oh man. I was looking forward to seeing you too. CT Chrysler, you guys. We got a true legend in the chat.
Goat CT.
Go check out CT Chrysler right now. Give him a follow. That man has supported me throughout the years. He's been on stream before too. Back in Sacra days. Mm-hmm. Good old times. We go way back. And yeah, we missed out on AX this year. I guess it was a good break because did too many shows last year. Too many. But it was a tradition. We would see each other like a quick, brief second. It would be kind of quick. And I should just be like, hearts in the chat. Next time, we gotta eat and chill, like hang out after the show. Mm-hmm. But you know CT. That's CT. GB. Yeah. You follow CT? Yeah.
Chat together.
Oh, yeah.
There. Back with the Ross and the Midas and the...
Oh, yeah.
Who else is there?
And yeah. And then we played Overwatch for a little bit. Oh man, that was we had this funny moment. Me and CT one time. It was the best.
No.
Oh man, it was hilarious. What we did was okay. I think you were playing as Anna, and I was Hanzo. And we were like at the base, at the enemy's base. I don't know the name of it, but like we're moving the payload with the big spaceship. This is early on. And like, look at this. Look at that sunset, CT. So we're all the way on the enemy's base. He's like, okay, I follow Jet. So CT was new to Overwatch 2 during that time. And I was mm-hmm. like, look at that nice sunset. I was like, okay, let's just sit down and watch the sunset. until they come out of the base. As soon as they came out, I trip and fall off. And I'm like, oh shit. And they try to, and then CT's like, where'd you go? Oh shit. And we just died.
Yeah. I remember one moment. We were all playing. Me, you, Ross. I think CT was there.
Yeah.
Somebody else. Adidas. I'm not sure if Adidas was playing, but Ross is like, okay, guys, we're gonna try something else, and then so he tells us to go lay down camp in this one area, right? Yeah. And then right when he gets there, Ross just gets sniped, and we're like, okay, what do we do now? we're like, what? Okay, our leader, no, what do we do?
Yeah. Oh man, that's good old times. But yeah, we're gonna wrap this up now, you guys. Thanks for joining on this stream tonight.
We'll
catch you guys later.
Yes.
Catch you guys later. See you guys. See you, CT. I'll talk to you later.
See you, Kenny. See you, everyone.
Bada ba boom. Bada ba boom. Good night. All
right.
Yeah. Hold on. I gotta play the exit.
Okay. Yeah.
We're still on.
Never mind. Yes, I'll do AX next year.
No, you gotta keep it down. That's not how it works. You gotta keep it down. I can't. You're using the same audio file as the background song, so if I turn you down, you can't hear the music, so shut up.
I'm sorry.
Good night, you guys. Thank you. Bye-bye, everyone. Bad dumb pieces.
We're good?
We're not good. Hold on.